make a big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place, singing,
We will rock you.
A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it!
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face. Big disgrace, somebody better put your bag into your place.
How has art impacted your life?
When I was a lot younger, I had a lot less confidence. I was really just really, really shy. I didn't have many friends, but I kind of escaped into books. And I think once I started doing, reading books really gave me this sort of beginning passion for art. And then when I started doing drama in middle school and high school and film, that really like brought me out of my shell and gave me this confidence that I can't really live without now.
Art has actually impacted my life hugely. From a very young age, I was unable to really participate in many physical activities because I have had surgery since I was about 4 years old. So as a student who wasn't able to be physically active, being able to involve myself in the arts and painting and drawing and stuff in school was really helpful, and it made me feel like I actually belonged.
I was never kind of an art person, but the second that I really got into it, it really started making things more positive. And it's kind of one of those big shifts in your life where you're like, oh wow, I can do this, I like this, this works. And when you find something like that, I don't know, it's just great.
Well, considering I'm trying to go to art school, they've impacted me a lot. I guess it's art is kind of like relaxing for me, and it really makes me not as stressed. And I think art is just really important to me because of that, and also because I love doing it. It's my hobby.
Well, I started doing MAPPA during the summers when I was like 10, and then I met a bunch of friends, and it impacted my decision to go to King Kekaulike High School instead of Gaye Charter High School, because I heard that the drama program here was really great, and I've made a lot of friends, and it's like a family.
Tenfold, really. Like, eighth grade visitation, we came to King K, and we watched, I want to say it's an excerpt. It was a short from The Outsiders, and I'm like, I have to do this. They get to use themes. And, you know, from then on, I was just 100% into, you know, the arts. I loved to draw beforehand. I was pretty proficient at that. I did a lot of film. Gone to like different independent film festivals where my video was actually chosen to go. So it's really impacted my life. It's turned my opinion of it completely around. Because, you know, when you're a kid, you're like, oh yeah, no, art people are real hippy dippy, and yeah, meh, 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 meh. And, you know, that was a really single, closed-minded opinion, but you know, I was a kid, so what was I supposed to do? But yeah, it gives you more opportunities to meet like better people, I would think. You know, just nicer people who you have more things in common.
Why is art important in schools?
The arts are important in school because you can express yourself. And when you're really learning how to express yourself through educational arts, it's a lot simpler, it's a lot more comfortable. You learn how to be yourself inside and outside of the real world.
I think the arts are important in schools because we learn so much math, English, and even though those are like extremely important, sometimes it's better for kids especially kids, to learn how to draw and how to do like arts and crafts, whether it be sculpture, ceramics, like painting, drawing, anything like that, because one, it's like a great creative it's a stress reliever, and it's just something you can do with your time that's not like being on the computer it's really important in schools because it's a stress reliever and a hobby.
It helps broaden to me. It helped broaden like my thought process, because I was a very closed-minded child. I grew up, I was an only child, so I had no social skills. I hated socializing with people, and then I did acting, and I'm like I know everyone now. I hang out with everyone. I try to at least.
So every person is talented in different areas, and if you tell students who aren't very good academically or who may not excel in sports and physical activities that they aren't good enough because they can't do that sort of thing, you're putting them down, basically. You're telling them that they're not going to be worth anything. But when you give them something that they can excel in, such as music or art or writing or performance, then you give them a space and you give them happiness and make them feel like they do belong and that they are worth something.
The arts, drama especially, gives you this dedication to hard work that comes from within you rather than like, oh, if you do a lot of hard work, you'll get an A. You get this inner motivation that like, if I work hard, I can make this good, I can make this beautiful, I can make this better than it would be if I didn't put in this effort. And you get this great work ethic showing that you can do things with hard work. You can really accomplish these great things, and that sort of transfers over to just the rest of your life.
It helps bring out the creative side in people and expand your imagination. And what will the world be without imagination?
How does it prepare you for life?
In general, they prepare you to think creatively and to come up with more creative and varied solutions to problems. And they help you kind of to get more perspective on the world. Like, you can view the world from a lot of different perspectives. And like, when you have students who are in drama or who take drama classes, then that helps them later in life to be able to portray confidence and to be happier, not happier, but it helps them to be more confident in areas such as business and social-wise, because they know how to pretend to be confident even if they aren't in a situation, which helps you get farther in life. Music helps in math and helps in bringing together both the left and right side of your brain. And like, art helps you to visualize different scenarios and aspects of things.
Well, I think everyone really should learn art because it's extremely applicable to people. Think it's not, but really, whenever you do something, whether you're buying like some brand of something, someone had to design that, someone had to draw that. Like, each building was drawn and designed, and people sometimes overlook that. But I think it's like extremely necessary for your future to at least have very minimal amount. Whether you're gonna, I mean, not everyone becomes an artist, illustrator, or fashion designer, but eventually you're gonna run into people that will need you to do something, at least designing.
Social-wise, I think they'd be perfect. It's because it helps get you ready for, like, I'm not gonna say peer pressure, but like anxiety, sort of. It's anxiety, to be honest. I couldn't go on stage, and then I went on stage, and I can go on stage now. That's everything that happened. A, B, and C.
Well, really, when you take an art, you sort of learn what you're good at, where you're placed. It's starting off of how you're gonna live your life, what you're gonna do later in your life. The arts really incorporate yourself into a type of work that you learn you're good at. So the more arts you do in like a school, the more you'll be prepared to go and find out what you're gonna do in your life, you know?
Well, as I said before, that great work ethic where you can really see from the very beginning of the idea, with hard work, you get this great product and just you get that great work ethic. And also, I take improv comedy classes, and I think improv comedy is the best thing to prepare you for life. You get to pretty much learn how to take just absolutely nothing and create something really cool and funny out of it. Just at the drop of a hat, get that creativity going, and just find a creative way to take limited materials and make something out of it with hard work. And I think that's something that you use in just every job, in life, in just all life skills are related to that.
Art would prepare you for life because in lots of jobs you need to use like your mind and think out of the box and think of new creative ways how to do things, because the world is ever changing. And we're going into like new, more modern society, and we need a bunch of new innovative ways to think of things. So art helps you think outside the box. Listen.